on, guys? It's your boy Jason Love coming at you with another video about CDL and non-CDL hotshot. In this video, I'm going to be talking about something that's super important. But before we get to that, I want to say thank you to all my subscribers. I think we're sitting right now at 492. I did take a little bit of time off for Christmas, uploading and everything. But I love you guys. I'm grateful for everybody who's able to go to my live streams. I had a couple live streams over the break. But now we're going to get back to running with our videos like normal. But yeah, don't forget, guys, we are doing a 500 subscriber giveaway, so if you want to be a part of that, there are 8 slots left, so go ahead, subscribe to the channel. I'll get everybody in there. We'll be giving away a lot of cool stuff. Also, to let you guys know, it's something that's going to be going down. I've hit up a lot of different hotshot drivers and owner operators, business owners on YouTube, because I want to start doing kind of a hotshot Q&A at least once a week with different owner operators of hotshot and kind of pick their brains, you know. So a lot of your favorites off YouTube are going to be on this podcast / Q&A that we're going to be having. I think we're going to start it on Wednesday. I got to check with the guy who's going to be on it, but I think Wednesday we're going to be doing that. So yeah, guys, that's basically where we're going with that. So let's go ahead and get on with the video. So today's video, we're going to be talking about basically how to book a load. I'm going to be going over some questions you need to ask a broker when booking a load. Basically everything you need to do start to finish to be able to book a load. So first off, congratulations. If you're to this point, you know, you've got all your ducks in a row, you're ready to book your first load. First thing you need to do is basically get on a load board. So whether you like to use Truckstop, which is what I usually use, or DAT load board, or Trucker's Edge, or Central Dispatch, or whichever one you like to use, you know, pick yours. But a load board's basically just going to show you the different loads in your area. You know, you do your searches, and I'll go over all this in a different video probably, but you'll do your searches, you know, and you'll say, I need to load 100 miles from my house. I live here. I need it to weigh this much or less. I need it to be this length or less, you know. I need it to be a hotshot load or like a flatbed step deck load. So you put all that in, you know, and then it's going to generate, you know, your searches. You're going to go through the different ones. You know, some are going to weigh different, be different lengths, are going to go to a lot of different places. Are going to be paying different. Some are going to be paying pretty good. Some are going to be paying really bad, you know. So you basically just choose from all of those loads. Like I said, I'll go deeper into that. I'll probably do like a live dispatching at one point, so you'll see that more. So let's say you find a load that you want, right? So you click on the load. It's going to give you all the information about the broker, okay? So it's going to give you the phone number, and your next move is to call said broker. So you dial the number, they're going to basically say, dispatch, and then you're going to say, hey, my name's so-and-so. I'm calling about, let's say, Las Vegas, Nevada to Sparks, Nevada. And they're going to be, okay, let me pull it up for you. So they're going to pull up Las Vegas to Sparks, Nevada. Usually what they're going to do is tell you the dimensions right off the bat. They're going to be like, yes, 20 feet, you know, it's 5 feet wide, it's 5 feet tall, 20 feet long, it's going X amount of miles, and it's paying X amount of dollars. Right? So in a perfect world, that's basically what they're going to tell you. Now, right here, I have some questions that I usually ask brokers when they don't give me enough information or for me basically to cover all the bases. So I want to go through these questions with you real quick. So first question I usually ask, if I already know the price that they're paying, obviously the first question you want to ask is ask the price, right? If it's not, the price isn't right or close to right, you don't want to waste your time on either parties, right? So questions I ask brokers, I'll be like, so what is being hauled? What is the item being hauled? That might give you a general, like, you know, picture in your mind of what's going to be on the trailer. What are the dimensions exactly? So sometimes, you know, these brokers, they don't really know what the item is a lot of times. You know, they've never seen it. They're kind of like a middleman. So make sure they have all of the dimensions exactly. How positive are you on the weight? This is an important question because if you're doing non-CDL, weight's going to be a big issue. You know, 1,000 pounds can make a difference. So especially if you're pushing close to your max. So if they say it's 9,500 pounds and your max is 9,700 pounds, really ask them how positive are you on the weight? You know, because if they're not that positive, it could definitely be 200 pounds more. You know what I'm saying? That could easily, that'll put you overweight. Especially if you're going to be doing more than one partial together, you want to make sure you know the weight, because weight's going to be a big thing for you. So I always ask them, how positive are you on the weight? And if they're not that positive, I usually have them call the person. If it's a load I really want, I have them call the person to see how positive they are on the weight, you know, and make sure I stay on the phone with them for sure. Next question I'll ask is, does it need to be tarp, chained, or strapped? Obviously, if it needs to be tarp, that's going to take a little bit more time. And if it's a big load, usually you can get paid more. If it needs to be a tarped load, if it needs to be chained or strapped, you know, if it's chained or strapped, usually pretty easy, strap it down, chain it down, no problems there. Does a 40-foot hotshot work? This is a question you'll need to ask if if it's not posted as a hotshot load. Obviously, if it's posted as a hotshot load, you know, it's perfectly fine. But a lot of times they're going to ask you, you know, what equipment you have. You tell them I'm a 40-foot hotshot. I have a 2019 Ford F-350 pulling a 40-foot gooseneck trailer. But sometimes they might not. They might just say, yeah, you can have it, you know, and you'll be like, well, does a 40-foot hotshot work? Because if you arrive there and it's your trailer needs to be deck height and you have a hotshot and you can't get loaded, like, you're going to waste a lot of time. So I always ask that question. If I feel like that hasn't been stated that I have a hotshot, I'll be like, does a 40-foot hotshot work? Another question is this considered a dedicated load or a partial? Now, this is an important question because I've had this problem a couple times where I've had a small load, let's say it's 10 feet, 2,000 pounds, and I thought it was a great partial, it was paying really good, but they wanted it to be a dedicated. By the time I got to the rate con and I read that it was a dedicated load, I wasn't 100% sure, so I had to, like, talk to the broker some more. Like, is this going to be dedicated? They're like, yeah, this is a dedicated load. We don't want you to put anything else on your trailer. And I said, okay. It was paying good enough for me to do that, so it wasn't a problem, but you might run into that problem. So make sure that you understand that it's supposed to be a dedicated load or it is a partial load. You can put other stuff on the trailer, no problem, right? And then the last question you can always ask, can we go a little higher on the rate con or on the rate for my deadhead? Or can we just go a little higher on the rate? I'd love to move it for you. I'd love to move it at this rate for you. So always be trying to get a little bit more money. I mean, at the end of the day, you are bartering with this broker. You know, they're holding on to some money, so you want to get as much money as possible because you're doing, you know, almost all of the work. So yeah, guys, I want to give you those quick questions. And after you ask those questions, right, and you realize, you know, this is a load that I want to haul, they're going to probably ask you for your MC number if they don't do that from the beginning. They're going to say whether you're set up with them or not. So if you're brand new, you're not going to be set up with them. They're going to be like, okay, what's your email address? They're going to send you a carrier packet. Now, our carrier packet's super easy to fill out. You are going to probably need something to be able to edit PDF files. I use Adobe Acrobat. Works great for me. Or you can print everything out and then scan it back onto your computer, which is, I feel, is more of a hassle. But if you have Adobe Acrobat, I think it costs me like $20 a month. You'll be able to fill out all the rate cons, everything you need to do. So they're going to send you, you know, their carrier packet, which is just going to be a contract. I'm going to throw up probably a dummy one so you guys can see it. It's pretty easy to fill out, you know, just fill out all the information on it. They're basically going to ask you all the information of your company. They're going to ask you for a W-9 form, which you should have. You should have had to send a W-9 form to your factoring company or whatever. So you send them a clean W-9 form, which I'll throw up a W-1 for you as well. You're also going to have to put them usually as a COI on your insurance. So that's the thing I was talking about in a different video where I basically call Progressive. I tell them the information of the company. They put them on the insurance, so they're basically able to look up your insurance. So in the future, if they're trying to use you, they can make sure that you still have, you know, verifiable insurance, cargo and everything that they need. So you put them as a COI, you get the W-9, they're going to ask you for a copy of your authority letter. So that's the authority letter you're going to get mail from the FMCSA. It basically says you're authorized to haul. So you should be getting that like 5 or 6 days after you actually get authorized. You'll get that in the mail. That's a very important page, so don't lose it. So yeah, send them a copy of your authority letter, send them a copy of your insurance, send them a copy of the W-9, and then fill out the carrier packet, and then, or the contract basically. You send all that to them. They're going to look it over real quick. They'll say, yeah, you're good to go. They'll send you a rate confirmation. A lot of people just call it a rate con. Look over the rate con. That should tell you how much you're actually getting paid. It'll tell you the exact pickup, the exact drop off. It'll tell you the weight, you know, the size and everything. I mean, I'll have all the information on there for you. If the rate con looks good, you sign it, which I do on Adobe Acrobat. You sign it, send it back to them. They're like, yeah, you're good to go. I usually send the rate con over to my driver so he knows the pickup and drop off, and then he's good to pick it up. So that's basically in a flash, you know, because I'm the flash, booking a load, asking the right questions, filling out the carrier packet. It's really not hard at all, guys. Like I said, one thing I am doing right now, if you guys just want help booking your first load, like you don't really want me to be your dispatcher, you want to dispatch yourself, but you want to be walked through booking your first load and filling out the information, if you go and sign up for my Patreon, it's just $10 a month. You're going to have my phone number. You're going to have one-on-one calls and video chats with me. And I'm going to be there for you when you book your first load so that it goes smoothly. So yeah, guys, that's everything. If you have any questions, yeah, I'll post my Patreon below. Like I said, if that's something that interests you and you just kind of want some guidance and all stuff, sign up for it. You know, it definitely helps me out a lot. I think I made it right before Christmas. I haven't really pushed it at all, but I already have one person signed up. So thank you, John, for signing up for the Patreon. It means a lot to me, guys. It really helps me out. So thank you guys so much for your time. Thanks for watching the video, and I hope you guys have a great day.